Jeff, and at every car show we go to, there's always one that's my absolute favorite. So Jeff, tell us about this beauty. What do we got here?
Well, this is a 1973 Buick Estate Wagon with a 455 cubic inch engine in it. My daddy bought this car brand new. I grew up in this car. It was my mom's daily driver.
Really?
It was originally the metallic green, or they call it the metallic pea green color, like you see in like Vacation movie and whatnot, similar color to that. And my dad painted it in the mid-80s, so this is what you see as the second color. It's got about 239,000 miles, full travel trailers and everything else. It's been around a lot of different places, and it's an interesting vehicle. It's got a clamshell rear end tailgate. It doesn't have a big swinging door, and it's all original 100%.
Show us what we got going on under the hood.
So it's all completely stock. 455 engine with a 4-barrel carburetor.
Now she looks original.
100% original, just quite dirty because it's never been completely cleaned out, but it's had one rebuild. Like I said before, it's got 239,000 miles on it. California original car, that's the original plate that came with it.
Wow. So she was originally bought in Cali?
Bought in California.
Okay. Yeah. So you got to Texas as soon as you could, huh?
Yeah, via Arizona.
Ah, all right.
Spent 4 years in Arizona with it and just got here about 3 months ago. Had to find a garage that it would fit in. That was the tough part. It's 19 feet, 4 inches long. So not a lot of houses out here have that depth of garage. So that was kind of one of the challenges when I moved here.
Definitely falls into the category of a land yacht.
Definitely.
So if you don't have a gigantic garage or a barn to park this in, you're going to be running into a little bit of trouble. And to me, she looks bigger than the new Escalades. This car is massive. So how much horsepower are you making out of this 454?
Just about 220.
Okay.
Nothing too extreme.
That's about what I thought. Love your air cleaner.
Yeah, I've repurposed that whole entire thing. I actually put about 7 coats of black lacquer paint on it. Peeled off the original 455-4 sticker. Found another one, got it. And when I peeled off the old sticker, it was perfectly pristine paint underneath. So I kept the old sticker for posterity's sake.
Wow.
And whatnot. So, you know, people say, have you ever been in a big boat? Because the nickname of this car was kids grew up in, it's called the tuna boat. Live in a big boat, you know how it drives. It drives exactly like a big tuna boat. So that's kind of a funny side thing, but that's what my brothers and I named it.
And that's why I called it a land yacht. The truest land yacht that we've got out here. Now, let's go take a look at this interior. What do you say? So they called it the Estate Wagon?
That's correct.
Was that a trim level? So tell us, do we have an original interior? What do we got here?
With the exception of the floor mats and the dash mat, everything is 100% original. And actually over the last few months is when the seat cracks happened. But other than that, everything is completely original. It's your standard vinyl interior. Nothing's been replaced and it looks amazing.
All right, so we're gonna give it the old cowboy hat test. Can I sit in this car with a Stetson on? Yep, so once you're in the car, plenty of headroom. Love this original vinyl. Remember, they're only original once. Now, let's go around to the back of this car and see the beauty that Buick put into the styling of this particular model. Whoa, we've got a tiger in the back. Tell us why we got a tiger back there.
You gotta drive with the fear.
That's right, Ricky Bobby, because if you ain't first, you're last.
That's right.
All I want to do is race, Daddy.
That's right. Well, I've had this car over 100 miles an hour before, and consequently, I blew the head gasket after that happened. When I was 17 years old, my daddy got really mad. But a neat feature about this car is the tailgate system and the window. It's called a clamshell rear end, and this comes up like this, and that closes.
Unbelievable that it still works.
Just a little help, and then the window comes down like that. So it's a space saver for when you're in the garage or whatever, parking area, so it's pretty nice. Comes back down.
And I really wish modern cars would incorporate this feature into what they're building now. It's totally different with the little one touch electric tailgate. But we've got a lot of room back here. And this is one hell of a grocery getter. You could about clean out Costco in one trip with this particular car. Love the back end. And tell us about this plate down here.
So, well, Arizona has their own historic vehicle plates. And in Arizona, they only give you one license plate. So it works perfect on the back. It's a really great looking license plate. That's pretty much it. Now that I'm here in Texas, I might try to keep that somehow. Another thing about this, with the back seat down, you can put a 4x8 sheet of plywood in this car, no problem. So it's definitely been used for that. We've hauled everything in this car as kids. And great shape.
Do you have a lot of brothers and sisters?
Just two brothers.
Just two. Yeah. So I wonder how many kids you could actually fit in there.
Well, with the seats, just what you can fit across the back, because there's no other seating back here. But okay. Some of the other versions of station wagons had the seats in the back, the rumble seats, but this one does not. It has a storage deck underneath, but that's about it.
Okay, so we've got two buckets in the front and then a bench in the back, which you could fit probably four fat kids.
3 to 4 people in the back easy.
And maybe 5 skinny kids. Yeah. All right, let's go around and take a look at the body lines of this car.
I just know this was painted about 35 years ago at a paint shop in San Diego area.
Yeah, and I'm noticing we've got quite a bit of flake going on here.
Yeah. You know, the car was always covered and meticulously, you know, housed, so it was never exposed to direct weather. And that's why it's still in such good condition.
Now, if there's one part on this car you do not want to break, it is right here. Look at this wraparound window.
Definitely one of a kind window. You can't find replacements unless you find it in a junkyard somewhere.
And what I like is it pretty much virtually eliminates blind spots. Because you can completely see. I love that. Love the luggage rack. Was this a dealer option? Or
no, it came factory.
Okay, so this one came factory on the estate wagon. All right, so we just got done touring this beautiful 73 Buick estate wagon. The owner was super friendly, and this is literally a car that never left the family.
Never.
So, passed down from father to son. And remember, if you've got a classic car at home, don't sell it on a whim. Don't sell it because you got angry because it broke. Keep it in the family, pass it down, because these types of cars and these types of stories, especially as electric cars come onto the scene, they've essentially became throwaway cars. Whereas this is something that he's going to keep forever. And again, thank you so much for taking the time to show us this car.
Appreciate it.
It is gorgeous. My favorite Buick out here. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.